I'm just gonna start out the video like this. We all know it, but I'm just gonna state it outright. Vegeta has come a long way since the Saiyan saga, and this new arc, the Galactic Patrol Prisoner arc with Moro, this new chapter definitely shows how far he's come.
Know your place, worm. Prepare yourself, damn Saiyan.
Now I will have some spoilers for the new chapter that comes out for the Dragon Ball Super manga, but it's not really anything because we don't have the scans. I haven't read it before anybody else. I just have a few pictures, one in particular that I wanted to look at and give you guys my thoughts on, but yeah, we just have a few pictures, and I don't see why anybody would not be wanting to listen to some spoilers for the manga anyway, because everyone's hyped for this shit. Everybody accepted Dragon Ball Super Broly spoilers, so here you go. Moro, let's start with this. Let's start with his design, first of all. Moro, I think, looks very interesting. He looks very uncomfortable, but I like the way they made him look very different than any other character. He looks like he's still a fighter. He looks like a goat, guys. That's duh, but his face, obviously, and his whole thing is goat. What I'm saying is that just the way his body's proportioned, he looks like an animal turned humanoid. And I like that they went this direction and didn't make him completely humanoid with a goat head. They made his body really weird and kind of elongated with long-ass arms and just a weird setup. But it does look like if a goat just morphed into a humanoid presence, that's what it kind of looks like. So I like that aspect of it. The fact that he looks like a barbarian, kind of, I don't really get the whole aspect behind it. If Moro used to be in a race that used to look like that, that had those clothes. So I'm not exactly sure if I feel like he looked better with this outfit on, or if he just looked better and much more badass with a shroud or a cloak. I think maybe with that he looked more mysterious, and maybe that kind of fed a little bit more into him. But obviously he can't fight with those on, so we have to take it as it is right now. And he looks pretty cool. I think he looks pretty interesting. His design looks interesting, and I really am digging it. I am curious to see how he fights. The body doesn't look like it fights very comfortably, but we'll see. So in this chapter, Vegeta is going to be fighting this guy, and we only have a few scans of him actually doing this, but there is one in particular that is interesting. Now, Moro uses his power to rip a Namekian out of his home on New Namek. He just rips him out, grabs him by the neck, and Vegeta is stunned at this. Like, he's shook in his facial expressions. And then, obviously, more than likely, he gets pissed off, and then he faces off against Moro. So, I'm hoping that the manga has a little side note where someone says, oh, Vegeta's on our side now, he's helping the Namek instead of killing them, because if you guys haven't watched the original Namek saga, do you guys remember this? Vegeta came to a village and literally slaughtered the entire village to the point where when they used the Dragon Balls to revive all the Namekians that Frieza had killed, since Vegeta technically wasn't working for Frieza at that point, it didn't revive his Namekians, and he literally just laughed about it. That's how sick and sadistic this guy was. Completely different than the guy showing the face like this that he shook that Moro's just strangling this poor Namekian kid. I really like that we got so much of a growth from Vegeta, from being a tyrant and an evildoer to being this, basically on Goku's level when it comes to not accepting bullshit like torturing Namekian children. And I definitely think that this can all be attributed to and thanks to Bulma. This would not be possible if Bulma was not in the cut, if she did not keep Vegeta on Earth and then had a son with him and gave him a family to protect and love. I think that would not be possible. We would not be here at Vegeta's growth and him being shook that Moro strangling this Namekian kid if this didn't happen. And I was just curious if you guys had noticed this. I posted on this on Twitter, so you guys probably knew exactly where I was going with this conversation, but let me know in the comments section below what you guys are anticipating for this chapter. Do you like Moro's design? Let me know in the comments section below, guys. This is going to be Blackscape signing off. Oh, and just one more thing. Thank you again for getting me to 80,000 subscribers. You guys are the squad. Take it easy.